A child who's involved with the violin is using kinesthetic, right, because they're feeling their hand and the amount of pressure they put on the bow, right? They're coordinating that information with what they're hearing, because there's a musical element to that. And then they're also looking at a piece of paper with the musical notes on it, and so they're interpreting that information visually. So they're taking all those different senses and blending them into one cohesive effort.
Harlan Brownlee, professional dancer turned educator turned president and CEO of Kansas City's Regional Arts Council, knows well the importance of a good arts program. One of the many benefits he sees in the cogs of Brandon Taylor's pre-concert performance. A tune-up that's taking place alongside the $47,000 piano that made the news when Governor Brownback called out its purchase as a prime example of frivolous spending.
The Sumner piano is an investment, and I hope that people would recognize that that instrument will actually gain value.
If you look at the response we got, we had a teacher send us a check and say, you know, I don't have a lot, but your kids, just like my kids, deserve a piano. So people get it, and I think they appreciate that our superintendent is willing to fight for things like that that are important.
As it turns out, fiscal woes put the district's arts and science school back in the news just a few weeks later when they elected to drop a theater class from the roster. Interestingly enough, that decision reflected more of a paradigm shift than an autocratic edict as administrators posed this question to the student body.
What do you want? What are you most interested in? So things like graphic design were really important to those kids. An international baccalaureate course in music theory. A lot of kids wanted photography. So how do we make sure that we're doing not just what we might have expected to be important, but for them? So theater will continue. It's just the specific class that we had, we're not gonna have.
But even before the latest round of budget cuts took effect, as proponents of arts in the classroom know all too well, fiscal shortfalls aren't the only gauntlet that's been thrown their way.
With the high stakes testing, you know, schools are being forced to make really difficult choices. And those choices are about instructing to what's on the test. So if it's not on the test, it's not taught.
It's rigid guidelines like these that prompted a desire for a more intuitive learning experience. The kind proposed by the Kansas City Metropolitan School of the Arts, a new private school slated to open its doors in the former Congregation Ohev Shalom building just in time for the fall semester.
We believe in kind of a Renaissance model or return to teaching. Going back to what we know in history, where everything was enlightened, we had a change in music, we had a change in architecture, and there was a sense of creativity. So we just feel that that's a catalyst for our students to take art and have a better understanding of what they're learning. We're going to hit the broad standards, but allowing teachers to teach that in the way they feel best and incorporating the arts on top of it. What we are not going to be doing is being held to the state assessments.
If we really want to have people who are engaged civically, if we want people to be the most fulfilled that they can to reach their greatest potential, we have to include arts in that formula.